Suitcase of Desalination, turning seawater into drinking water with a single button. Fresh water is vital to many life forms on Earth, but we are facing a shortage of fresh water because of drought and lack of rain. While we got frozen supplies in the North and South Poles, experts advise not to touch them or risk facing irreversible consequences. To fight shortage, desalination came to be. So how can we make this process more accessible and cheaper? Scientists have a solution stored in a suitcase. Before we look into that suitcase, let's talk about desalination. If you don't know, it is a process of removing excess salts and other minerals from water. According to Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service, most desalination processes need feed water to be treated, which produces two streams of water. Treated water becomes fresh water with low concentrations of salts. Brine water has higher salt concentrations. Although we got the tech for desalination, several challenges are super serious. The first is the environmental impact of discharging the concentrate from treated water. Another is the budget, which not many nations can handle. At the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, scientists have an offer, a suitcase for desalination. They were able to build a portable desalination unit weighing less than 10 kilograms. If power is the issue, users can plug in a small portable solar panel costing $10 online. The team boasts that it can produce drinking water with exceeding scores of the WHO quality standards. We worked for years on the physics behind individual desalination processes, but pushing all those advances into a box, building a system, and demonstrating it in the ocean, that was a really meaningful and rewarding experience for me, said senior author Jong Yun Han. Published in the journal Environmental Science and Technology, scientists solved two major hurdles in desalination processes, filters and high-pressure pumps. The pumps aren't easy to miniaturize, thus they applied a technique called ion concentration polarization, 10 years in the making. ICP uses an electrical field to membranes, and these membranes repel positively or negatively charged particles, including salts and germs. The charged particles are fed into the second stream of water for discharge, leaving fresh water in the first stream. To optimize the process, they deployed electrodialysis modules to eliminate remnants. Enhanced by machine learning, the setup features a two-stage ICP and one round of electrodialysis. They said this minimized power consumption without compromising performance. They tossed the feed tube into the water during beach tests involving different water salinity and cloudiness. Half an hour later, a plastic drinking cup with clear drinkable water was produced. The prototype model can generate drinking water at 0.3 liters per hour using only 20 watts per liter. This is possible with a portable solar panel. What's your take on this device? Is desalination the solution to water supply issues? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.